No, there's not. Bob Grady went through the ethics office at the Department of Treasury before he was involved with anything like that, and got clearance from the ethics office at the Department of Treasury, did exactly what he's supposed to do. So no, there isn't. And I can't say it more unequivocally, and you keep asking the question. I have never once had a conversation with anyone in the Department of Treasury or any member of the Investment Council, including Mr. Grady, about what they do over there. Governor Corzine was very involved with that, as you know. I think it's inappropriate for a governor to be involved in that. And I have not been involved 1 minute of one day since I've been governor in what they do over there. They make the decisions. Those are investment professionals who they hire and have in the departments and on the council. And if you look at the people that I've appointed to the State Investment Council, it's been bipartisan folks. Our vice chairman is Tom Byrne, who's a former state Democratic Party chairman. And all of the folks that I've put up there are investment professionals. I let them decide. I don't want to have anything to do with it. My own things are in a blind trust. I am so uninterested in investments at this stage of my life. Depending on how much money I come out with when I get done in this job and find out what's left, I might be more interested. But I'm not interested, and I don't involve myself for a moment in it. So no, there's no appearance issues or anything else. And the article that spurred all this conversation has been written by a guy who is a completely discredited journalist, who's been fired for being inaccurate and inflammatory before. So, you know, right now, anybody who can, you know, pop up on a website calls themselves a journalist. David Sirota is not a journalist. He's a hack. And so, you know, Bob Grady went through the things that he needed to go through to get ethics clearance to be involved in my campaign. And by the way, he's been a friend of mine for nearly 40 years. So the idea that that guy would not have something to say and give me some advice, especially given his history in this state, working for Melissa Fenwick, working for Governor Kaine, is preposterous. Yeah, he gives me advice politically, not on investments. I don't get any advice from him on investments because I have a blind trust. And nobody in this office, and most particularly me, gets involved with what happens at the State Investment Council, who, by the way, they don't make the decisions either on the individual things that we buy. They set out categories of the way they want to see it done. And then professionals that we hire, both in the Department of Treasury and outside, have made those choices. And by the way, over the last 4 years, their performance is $12 billion above the assumed rate of return, which is pretty high to begin with at 7.9%. We lowered it to make it more realistic than it was in the Corzine administration. But 7.9%, and we've made $12 billion over 7.9%. So I'm sure there's lots of people in America who would be happy to substitute the performance of our Treasury Department and the State Investment Council with theirs, given the returns that we've gotten. So, you know, this is really, and I will tell you that this is why people don't want to get into public service. You know, Bob's getting this level of abuse. He lives in Wyoming. He flies here at his own expense every month to preside over the State Investment Council. He gets no remuneration for the performance that he does on the State Investment Council. He goes to an ethics office and gets cleared to do what he did in terms of giving me advice politically. And he still has to take abuse from you people. So this is why, when you wonder why it's tough to get people in it and why I think Fox is crazy to get back into this, but I'm happy to be the beneficiary of his lunacy. What goes on in this building with your participation is what discourages people from getting involved in public life. So definitely not. Heather.